Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to High Point for our Thursday Night Local. This is the July 7th edition. We are going to be competing tonight on course number 2. And this is a very special tournament here because our good friend Kevin Dickey is here in the white shirt, blue cap, or gray cap, I should say. He is playing for the first time in our local program this season. And he has graciously donated $100 toward the purse. So we'll have a nice, healthy purse tonight, and everybody will get paid. We have 11 players. And the temperature right now is 88 degrees. We have partly the mostly cloudy skies, and it's very humid. Humidity is at 75%, giving us a heat index of 95. Winds are very light. And let's walk over here to present the pairings for tonight.
So no leave without getting at least $8 because of Dale.
These waters will be first on the team. We're playing in threesomes except for the twosome at the end. And we're on our way. On hole 1. And Keith starts with an ace. Next up, this is Frankie Peters. Sorry about that. Frankie will get a 2 there. And our third player tonight, this is Brett Newman. Brett's going to miss to the right. Brett will have his 2. And just slips it in. Now we're on hole 2. Just this is right.
To hit it harder and it would go in, and
and he'll have a 2.
That's the line. I mean, it's the line if you hit it harder.
Frankie on the tee. Frankie also misses and hits the block. He'll get a 2. Oops. No, that's a 3. Because he nonchalantly backhanded his deuce and it kicked away from the hole. All right, Brett on the tee. That's in. Good putt. All right, Brett will be on the tee at 3. Yep, he got a slide off that left rail. He'll have his 2 there from the back rail. Here's Keith Waters. Keith just left of the cup.
How did that ball not break in?
That's a tapped in par. Let's go now to 1 with our second group. This is going to be Burnett Block on the tee. Jeez, missed right. She'll have her two. Now next up, this is Russell Sigmund. Russell's going to get it. Good putt.
Sweet.
Third and final player of this second
the
group.
Now it's gone. I meant to tell you what I said.
This is Graham Sigmund.
Notice some W's since the point.
Not
here. Did you want to escape?
This is off the pipe, and Graham will get his two.
If I didn't, congratulate you. It's your favorite.
Let's go up to four. On the tee, it's Frankie Peters. Gonna go left, and that'll be a two for him. And we're going back to one. Here's our next threesome. And it's Dylan Robertson. And he starts out with an ace. Good putt. Second player is Chase Ferguson. This is right, and he'll go for his two. And our third and final player of this threesome, this is Randy Simpson. Flip. I think he'll get us two there. We'll go to three. Graham said he's going back door with this shot. Good. Not a bad run at it. He'll have a two. Where's Russell sitting on the tee? Now he's missed left. That'll be a two for him. Let's go over. Well, we'll stay on this hole. She's going to be short by about 4 feet, and that'll be a two putt there, and we'll go back over to two. Dylan's going to miss left. She's at the back rail. Alright, you guys, two there. Alright, let's go to seven first time. Frankie Peters will be on the tee. The hole is over there behind that block, over on the corner there by the rail. Oh, it's right. Better. Nope, he's got a long beach putt. He's about to go up and back again. Going back to one. Our final players of the night on this hole. And this is Kevin Dickey. Waiting for the first time this season in a local event here. He'll get a two. And with him is Dale Crotts. And he starts out right. They'll get a two. And all the players are now teed up and on the course. For the first time, we're going to hole number five. Ramp Sydney will get a, oh, good putt. This is Russell's segment. Russell will be short. And let's go to eight. This is a par putt for Brett Newman. And he gets it there. Now on the tee, Keith Waters. Set off the rail. There's an oh my god right there from Keith. And now he'll go for two. Good putt there. We'll go to six for the first time. Straight hold. And Graham hit it too firm. Guess it right. We'll go back to eight. Frankie's tee shot is left as well. Let's go back to six. And it's Russell's second on the tee. That started right. It's going to stay out there. So Russell will get his two. All right, for the first time, we'll go to nine. We'll see Brett Newman on the tee. Off that back hill, and it's in, good putt. What a four. Here we see Chase Ferguson's tee shot. That's gonna have to come off the back rail, and it crosses over. And Chase gets two. Let's go to seven. This will be Graham Sigmund on the tee. Off that block and just misses right over the five. And this will be Randy Simpson's tee shot. Just skin past the cheese. Well, actually, it's not a cheese, it's more of a brick, but he got his two there. Let's move up the, well, let's stay on this hole with Dylan Robertson. That's gonna be right, and let's go to four. Dickey just hit a little too firm to get that brake to go over. He'll have his two. It's make five. And Jake Ferguson on the tee. That's going to stay out right as well. He'll have his two. Let's go back to four. We'll see Dale Crotts' tee shot. He's going to miss left. Let's go to eight. And Sigmund. That's going to be left as well. All right, for the first time, we'll go to 11. And Brett Newman pulled his tee shot. Should have his two. Okay, checking in with Keith Waters. Fan for Keith, good putt. Now Russell for his par on eight. Got it there, it's back to 11. He's going to go get it. Good putt. Over to nine. And the next tee shot. Goes in. Good putt. Off that back hill. All right, we go to 12 for the first time. And he gets it. Dead center. Good putt. Rams tee shot. Now too much over that hill, so he'll have his two. Back to 12. Frankie's tee shot. Too far to the right. We'll go to six. And just saw the old Crotts ball jump in the cup. Good putt. I dropped seven. On the tee, Chase Ferguson. Oh! Alright, Chase has a long deuce putt from about 8 feet away. Two to 13 for the first time. And Keith Waters gets it. Good putt. And we stay on the pole there. This is Frankie on the team. Tee shot is also left. Down the hill it goes. Back to 13. And Brett gets it, trips it. Back to me. Chase got the two. On the tee now, Dylan Robinson.
When he came off the rail.
that's gonna come up short. And that's a 2 there. Let's go to 14. This is the hole where you play left rail, back rail. And this would be Frankie Peters. Nope. Too strong off that back rail. Over to 7. Dale Crotts to the shot. It's going to be right. He'll get the 2 there. Okay. Back to 14. Now that's going to kick over there as well for Brett. Let's go to 12 now. Okay, we'll be on the tee first. Annette misses there. Going for her 2. Here's Keith on 15. Playing his great shot. And this is right. And Graham on 12. He's going to also miss right back to 15. Here's Russell on 12. That's also right. And he'll get a 2. I don't know why it's in my head, but every time I see the 3 of you putting here, I'm wanting to call her Jennifer.
Oh. That's okay. That's my youngin'. All mine.
All right, we're going to walk over to 10 for the first time. And that was Dylan for his 2 there. Back to 16 for the first time. We'll get another look at Tim and Kevin and Gail get on that hole. He's going to miss right. Oh, it turned back. And not a word from him about that. All right, we're going to 11. Andy Simpson for his 2. Got it. And back to 16. Frankie's going to be hitting this 5-foot beach putt. All right, whipped out there. Let's go back to 11. Good putt, Chase. Now back to 16. Put that Brett back to 11. Dylan's going to get it as well. Good putt. Now we have the 10 for the first time. Reality here. Kevin's going to be on the tee first. Thank you. 11's going to be in there, a good putt.
I was at a 17 for the first time.
I didn't think it looked too short, but back to 10. Dale's tee shot, that's short. That should be a makeable two there. Let's go to 15. Russell Sidney's tee shot. No, it hit the second pipe. He's got a long deuce putt. It's a good 20 feet out. You get a check on that in a moment. Let's go to 18. Here's Brett on the tee. And that's going to go in. Good putt. All right. Russell is not going to get his two. Not sure what options he had. Thought maybe the ball broke right to left. He's checking his grip. He did have some issues with that during the Monday night local in Burlington. However, he did win the tournament with a score of 79. There's 11. That was way left. Let's go back to 15. Graham's on the tee. Graham's to the right. He'll go for his two. Let's go to 12. And Kevin missed it to the right. All right, going to go to 14. There's Chase's tee shot. That drops in, good putt. Back to 12. Dale, that looks like it's right. And over to 16. Graham's missed to the left. He should get his two. Let's go over to 14 again. This will be Randy Simpson on the tee. Oh, nice putt, Randy. Over to 13. Good putt there, Kevin. All right, the 15. Chase is in there. Good putt. Back 17. The next tee shot, roll back and in, good putt. Right back to 15. Andy Simpson. All right, our lead group is already underway in their second round. We are going to go to the score sheet in a couple minutes here. Good putt, Randy. And now Dylan Robertson. That is in there as well. Good putt. Over to 17. No, Russell did not get it to swing over there to the back rail. Now here's Dylan's tee shot. I'm sorry, Chase's tee shot. Popcorned it in. That's an ace for him. Russ has got the deuce still on 17. Now we go back to 16. And Simpson's tee shot. That's left. I go up for his two. We go up to 18. All right, Burnett got her two. On the tee, Graham Sigmund. That should go back. No, it crossed up. It crossed up the hill there. He'll close the first round with the par. Let's go to hole three. We're in the second round here for this group. Thank you, Peters, will be on the tee. Right, gonna go in there for Frankie. Good putt. And we're gonna check out Brett Newman.
He ran off that guy, put it in first round. Gonna hold on.
He's gonna miss right, so that's a two for him. We go now to 17. Randy Simpson missed his tee shot to the left. We'll go back to four. We're going to see Frankie on the tee. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah. Alright. Oh, caught the left foot. Back to 18. Yeah, he had that problem Monday night.
Yeah.
All right, let's go to the scoreboard here. Well, not too shabby. Keith and Brett are in at 28, leading the way. All right, going to five. Shot. This is right. Just skims past the hole. And on the tee, Brett Newman. That is also right. A little too strong there. We are now going over to 18. This is our final group to complete the first round. Kevin Dixon first on the team. Kevin's going to the back rail. He'll have to putt for his team. He'll move up to back to the first hole. Actually, going to the second hole. Net block on the tee. Kevin got two. She got it. Good putt. Back to 18. Dale Crotts to complete round number one. He went left and all right, he'll have a two putt. It's about 6 feet away. All right, looked out there. We'll go back to hole two. Russell Sigmund changing putters after the first round, and he made it. And he shot 34 that first round with that grip issue there. Let's go back to one. Here's Chase Ferguson's tee shot. That's right. Excuse me. I got the two. And Burnett's tee shot on three. Comes up short. She'll get her two. And let's check out Graham Sigmund. That's in there for Graham this time. This time. Back to one. Randy Simpson is off the back pipe and might have enough room for his two there. Let's go back to three there. This is Russell for his two. All right, let's go over to the scoreboard here. Everybody is done with the first round. Now all I see is a blank score sheet. Could have waited like another 3 minutes while I'm filming here, and then just to keep the suspense going.
Yeah, I should have turned it slowly.
No. 3 minutes, turn the page, and then, you know, let it go. Okay, so Keith and Brett are going to be your leaders at 28. Chase is at 29 with Kevin Dickey. And that keeps you up to date here. Here's Vanette's tee shot on four. Caught the left lip. We're going to move up to eight. One of our two co-leaders that's in the house with the lead. Getting ready to tee it up. Here he is, Brett Newman. And Brett will putt for his two. Over to five now. Graham will be first on the team.
Don't do that.
Graham's gonna get it. Nice shot. Alright, on the tee for that block. That is short. That'll be a tap in too. Alright, here's Russell on the tee. As well, back to nine. Wrecks the shot. Drops in front door, good putt. Go to four. Chase will be on the tee. He was one off three after the first round. It's left, and we'll go back down to 10. Stand on the steps here. Stand on the bench. That will be first on the two. And there's an ace for Brett, now Keith on the tee. That's in for Keith, good putt. Let's go to five. Chase missed right, and he'll head up to seven. Russell signals to shot. It's gonna miss there to the right. Now, where did the ball end up? Behind the block? Nope, in line for his two. Let's go to 11. Brett moving two shot. That's in for Brett, good putt. Here's Keith Warner. That's gonna come up just short by about 6 inches. Back to five. Randy Simpson's two shot just misses right. And let's head to four. Kevin will be on the tee, it looks like. One off the lead. Actually, let's go over to six right quick. Chase's tee shot, drops in, good putt. Quickly to 12. Brett's tee shot misses right. And let's go to eight. And oh, Burnett got a little bit of hosing here. She hit the left pipe and it bounced off the left rail, and now she's stymied. She's in a heap of trouble for her two putt. Let's go to 12. Well, Keith got a good putt. Kevin got the tee shot on four, good putt. All right, well, Burnett on her two putt, skimmed that particular pipe, and it's now down there. Now she's going for four. Let's go to 12. Thank you, old Miss Wright. He'll go for his two. Let's go to 8 again. Russell's tee shot. Well, he's safely staying up there for his two. Let's go back to 5. Kevin Dickey's tee shot. Oh no, he's behind the block. He hit it too early. And we'll have to watch, see how he does with his goose putt in a moment. I guess Vinette's doing a demonstration of her deuce putt. Alright, we're gonna go to 13. Now you're not gonna be able to see the hole well with that flower bed right there, but Brett got it to putt. Short of a hill. He's got about a 4, he's got about a 5 footer for his 2, but it's not easy to hit. And he got it. Alright, Kevin's still on his deuce putt on 5. Here's Graham Sigmund on 9. Graham missed right. Let's go to 8. Chase is going to be just left. It raised the left foot. We go back to 5. Still sizing up his deuce putt there for Kevin Dickey. Oh, tried a two railer and it doesn't go, but that was a great run. Let's go back to 8. Dillon's tee shot. He's down the hill and missed it right. Go back to 5. Dale Crotts on the tee. He's short, but he'll get a 2 and take the honors away. All right, we go to 15 now. Keith's going for his 2. All right, Brett Newman on the tee. Right as well. He'll have his 2 from the back rail. We'll go to 6 now. Let's see if Kevin can recover from that disastrous 3 there on the previous hole. There he goes. Good putt. Let's check out Chase on 9. Door shot. Nope, missed left. He'll go for his 2. Let's go over to 12 now. Graham Sigmund's tee shot.
Station. Back to 9.
Andy Simpson, good putt, over the 15. Thank you, Peters. He's going for his 2. Apparently, he hit that second pipe down the fairway. He's got about 16 feet for his par. He's banking it off that right rail, and it's going to be left. All right, that's a 3 for Frankie. We'll go now to 10. Actually, let's go to 8. Kevin, Dickie's tee shot. You know, he's going to be hitting the pipe as well. Fortunately for him, it's down a hill. Right, 16. Right to him. Nice putt for Brett. Let's go back to 10. Here's Chase Ferguson's tee shot. Chase will get it as well, good putt. We go back to 8. Now Vanette's gonna show Kevin what she did. Same line that Kevin did, except Kevin hit a little bit firmer. Kevin did get the 2 from him as well. Now we'll check it out with Dale Cross. That's going to go left as well. He's going to go for his 2 from the back rail. All right, 17. Brett Newman will not get it over there, and he'll get his 2 putt. All right, let's move to 11. That is in for Chase. Good fight. Over 9. Kevin's tee shot. Gets in front door. Good fight. Here's Keith on 17. It's going left. Keith will go for his 2. That's about 4 feet away. It's back to 9. Dale's tee shot. Oh, it's around 360 and it still goes in. Good putt. Up to 18. Brett Newman on the tee. Back door, would be 2 for 2. Yes, he will. Good putt. let's go to 15. And actually, you know what we're going to do? Our rare dual coverage here. This will be Jennings Robinson on 12 and Graham Sigmund on 15. Dylan missed it right flip. Graham got the tee shot. Good putt. And Frankie Peters on 18, this left. And he'll have his 2. Back to 10. see Sean's doing good putt. Here's Keith on 18. Has a chance to go in back door as well. Yep, good putt. And back to Kent. Hit it way off that rail, but it still goes in good putt. Over to 16. Here's Russell's tee shot. Got it, good putt. And let's do dual colors to Burnett on 16 and Kevin Dickey on 11. The next going to be right. Kevin looks to be short and he'll get his two. There we go. All right, we're now going to start the third round. Right limit on the tee. He is in at 58. But we'll have a long goose putt there after he hit that last pipe. He got it. And Keith Waters in at 50-62. He pushed it. All right, we'll see Frankie on the tee. And that's it for Frankie. Good putt. All right, we're gonna walk over here and give you the scores here out of that first group just to keep you up to speed here. Keith Waters holds a two-shot lead at this juncture here, but you still have the remaining eight players on the course yet to report, including two players that were in at 29. Here's Graham Sigmund on 18. Oh, he almost got a front door. Hit the back of the cup. Back to two. Tee shot for Brett Newman's in. Good putt. And now Keith on the tee. That's right, and it doesn't come in off the block, so he'll have a one-shot lead on Brett. Back to 18. And Brett will not get it back door, so he'll have a two there. All right, let's see, where we gotta go? Let's go to 16. Dylan's tee shot. Misses left. All right, we're going to move up to three now. Brett Newman's on the tee. Get in for Brett. Yep, good putt. We're staying with Keith Waters. And Keith will miss it left. We go to 17. Chase's tee shot. That's got to hurry. It does not go in. So change with one back of the leader through the first round. Brent Newman on four. Ooh, caught the right lip. So Brent will have his two to remain 200 for the round. And Dylan Robertson on 17 for his deuce. We go now to 15. Kevin Dickey was also one back of the leader back in the first round. He's gonna get it, good putt. Now back to four. In fact, got a good two there. Here's Keith on the tee. Even par through three holes. Let's check out Chase on 18. All right, this is right. Okay, some little critter is on the outskirts of the tee pad there. I gotta remember it's Keith. And Keith will miss it. He'll have his two there. Let's go back to the clubhouse here.
Yeah.
And Chase is writing the scores in. All right, Brett missed five. He stays 200 for the round. Oh, Chase is at 57, sandwiched between Keith and Brett. We go to 17 now. Good putt for Kevin. Let's go to five. And Keith left that one short, so he's 0 for 5 this round. Yeah, let's go to three. I'm watching Brett on six as well. I think this will be Burnett on the tee. Brett is a foot short for his two. So he's still 200 through six. Still tied for the lead. Chase is currently one back as he starts his final round in a couple of moments. Nice putt for that. 18. Tee shot may go in. No, it caught the right lip. Back six. Keith misses right, so he'll have his two. Brent Newman and Keith Waters are presently tied for the lead. Brent was two back to start the round, but he made two and three. catch them. And we'll go back to 18. This will be the end of the second round after Dale completes his play on the hole. Off the back rail and left. All right, back to one. Not yet, we're gonna go to seven. Back off the block. Doesn't go in. All right, Keith on the tee now. That's not gonna get it. So he remains even par. And we'll go to the clubhouse. Checking on Kevin's score.
Yeah.
Chase is going to start his third round. He's yet to appear on the tee. It's Randy Sipsa will be on the tee right now. We have 27-30.
Yep.
So Kevin will be tied with Keith for the lead.
Well,
very nice.
56, Chase. A stroke back at 57. Here's Chase on the tee at one. Starts out with a deuce. Back to eight. Right for his two. Got it. And now Keith Waters. Gonna be his first ace of the round. One under. And let's go to five. Burnett block on the tee. And she's short. And Keith got the fish out on nine off the back of the hill, so he goes to two under for the front nine. We go to two. Andy Simpson on the tee. That's left. There's Frankie on nine. The back hill. Good putt there. Right now on the tee. This is Brett Boomin. Chase is now on the tee at two. Chase got it. So did Brett. So Brett goes to 300 for the round. Chase is one under through two. Keith is two under through nine. Rams tee shot misses right. Over to 10. And Keith got me three in a row after an 0 for 7 start. Let's go to one. Final round beginning for Kevin Dickey. Chase is on three as well. Chase is going to get it. And so will Kevin. So Kevin is two under. I'm sorry, Chase is two under through three. Here's right on 10. That's in for Brett. He's now at 400. That puts him at 90. He's at 89. Randy Simpson on 4 for 3 for his deuce. Good fight. All right, here's Keith on, oops, here's Keith on 11. And that puts Keith at 88 at this moment. 400 for the round. Here's Dylan's tee shot on 3. That goes right. And Kevin missed his tee shot on 2. So he should get his 2 there to stay 100 for the round. We'll go over to 11 again. Frank is going to hit that block, it appears. Oh no, it just passed it. But it stopped short. Alright, here's Chase on 4. No, he hits the block. A little bit surprised at that. Now we go to 11. He's just a stay shot back. That's going to be left, and he's going to get his 2. So he keeps at 400. Same with Brett. And Chase did get the 2 there on hole 4. Let's go to 8. Keith made 12. He's made 5 in a row since his imperfect start there on the first 7. Right, Graham got his 2. And now we'll see Russell Sigmund on the 2. Way short. That's going to be for a 2 there. Let's go to 3. Kevin Dickens on the tee at 1 under par this round. He's going to wind up left and he'll have a 2 there. And Brett missed the tee shot on 12. He stays 4 under for the round. Now he's 3 back on the tee. We go down to 13. And he's made 6 in a row to 5. Chase will not get it there. He's 200 for the round. Got his 2. There's Graham Sigmund on 8. I'm sorry, on 9. He's perched on top of that hill there. And he got his 2. Let's go to 13. Right, moving on the tee. Gonna go in, good putt. So he goes to 5 and before the round. Let's go to 4. Nope. Left, caught the left rib, wasn't going back door. Up to 14. Keith is still 6 under. He missed the hole there. Brett needs it to get to 6 under. And it misses left. 5. Oh, I'm sorry, 6. Oh, Chase got the right whip. He's going for his 2. Go over here. 4. Well, okay, put it back over there. Let me see where we're at here. Let me just get over here. Okay, he's going to have to come back in line this way. If he spaces out, he'll have a clearance.
So come back straight back.
You're going to have to come straight back in my direction using the card.
But can he move it out to here?
Well, he can move. If he uses the card, if he uses the full card, he'll be, yeah.
How about if he takes a partial?
Partial, card? he can come straight out, yeah.
But I can't. Can I come straight back?
You can come straight back, yes.
That's what I want to do.
Okay.
I don't have any other shots. I just want to get it off of that block.
Okay, you can take a little more than that if you need it.
No, it won't matter.
All right, 15. Well, Keith got a 2. He stays at 6 under. Brett's on the tee. He misses right. He stays at 5 under. Let's go to 7. Go back. Nope. He's going to be short. And that's a 2 for Shay. He stays at 2 under for the round. Here's Kevin Dickey at 1 under for the round. Oh, Kevin, wait, this time he's on the positive side of that rock there. That's a 2 for Keith. Oh, Kevin, excuse me, here's Keith on 16. Picking it up to go to 7 under. Brett's at 5 under, needing this one desperately. Nope, yo, yeah, good putt. He's 6 under, but he's running out of holes. Here's Chase on 8. Nope. Oh, he's going for his 2. Let's go to 6. So Keith at the moment will be at 85 with 2 holes to play. Brett will be at 89. Kevin's gonna get it to go to 200. Chase for his 2. Oh wait, that was a 360. He's back down the hill. He's gonna drop at least 1 stroke there. Here's Keith on 17. Oh, he got it. He's going to be 8 under. He's going to end up at worst at 84. And Chase got his 3, so he drops to 1 under for the round. Here's Dylan Robertson on the tee. Nice putt for Dylan. And Brett will not get 2 shot on 17. He'll have a 2. Here's Kevin Dickey on 7. Good putt. He's 3 under now. So don't count him out just yet. Dylan got it. Still on mine. There's Randy Simpson. I haven't seen him in a while tonight. For Randy to play. And now Keith on 18 with his 2. And that's a third straight 28 for Keith to finish at 84. Chase will be on 90. Off the left lip, off the block. So that's going to be a par. And on set, 8, this is Kevin Dickey for his team. So he's 5 down to Keith with 10 to play. And Brett Newman for his 2, he ends up with a score of 89 by my count. Let's go to 15. Alright, good putt for Russell. Let's go to 10. Dylan Robertson will be on the tee. Nope, he hit it too early. That's a 2 for Dylan. And let's look at Burnett on 15. Good putt.
Yeah.
Chase got the tee shot on 10. He's 2 under for the round. He's going to have to really work on the back just to catch Keith. 9. Chase is on the tee at 11 as well. That is. His shot is definitely an hole behind the block. Kevin's going to be just right, so he'll shoot 3 under for the front 9. Chase for his 2 on 11. He's going to drop the 1 under again for the round, but he's only at 92. So he's out now. He's in at 84. Here's Dale on the tee at 9. And off the right lip. And back again. One more time. Yeah, good putt. All right, we're going to make a walk up here to the scoring area here just to make sure we are on the same page here as far as what is the score to beat. All right, there was a Yankee update.
6-2.
Wow. Yeah, it is Keith at 84 with running rounds of 28. That's the score to beat. Kevin's the only opportunity that can catch him. He's only 3 this round. And here he is on 10. Nice putt. Go to 17. There's Greg Sigmund on the tee. He's short there, but he'll have his 2. Let's go. Let's go to 11.
Yeah.
I guess they'll get it within four. Nice putt. Tied with Brent Newman for second at the moment. All right, we go to 18. These three are not going to come anywhere close to our top players at the moment here, but it's always fun to see the Sigmund family on the tee. And Jennifer will go for it too. All right, she'll end up with a three. All right, Russell will be on the tee. Actually, Kevin's on the tee at 12. Let's go to him right quick. Nope, misses left, so he'll stay at 400 for, I'm sorry, 500 for a round. And Russell misses left. That's going to be a two there. Let's go back to 12. Nice putt there for Dale. All right, and now we'll check out Graham Sigmund on 18. Back door. And he misses right. So we now focus with Kevin Dickey going to the final six holes. He's only three down to Keith Wallace. He's at 87. Then good putt. You got a 15. Okay. That's left for Chase. He'll have it too. All right, here is Dylan Robertson. Hit the pipe. All right, he's got about 3 foot for his two. All right, here's Randy Simpson. Kevin's getting ready to tee up on 14. Hit the third pipe. He'll have about a 5 foot for two. Let's go to 14. Kevin's tee shot. Now he's 400 on the back, 7 foot around, one behind Keith. All right, here's Dale Crotts. This is right. Let's go to 16. Here's Dylan on the tee. And he misses right. He'll have his two there. Back to 15 now. So So six strokes over the last four holes. Kevin Dickey will be your winner. You'll get two of them right here. You'll stay within one of the lead. Seven shots, not six. So he's got, he needs five shots to win. Five shots or less between the last three holes. Let's go to 17. And these two shots could be way short, and that's a two. And Dale Kratz on 15 gets his deuce. Let's go back to 16. Okay, 17. Yeah, back door for Chase. Good putt. Over to 16. That's not going to get it. He misses right. Dylan on 17. And he got his two. Let's go 16. Be good. Nice. Ooh, caught the right lip. All right, to 18. And Sips is on the tee. This is left back 17. Kevin leads at least 1/8 over the last two holes. This could be one of them. Yes, get back. And he got, oh, missed the two there. So, we're going to finish out on 18 with the remaining players on the course. Dylan will finish it with an ace. So the surgery situation is, Kevin is tied with Keith. He's got to make this to win. For the win. Back door. Oh, nah, that is nasty there. So once he taps in his putt, he's going to be at 84. We won't know if Keith and Kevin will go for a playoff or just split the first place prize. Dale got his two. Okay, so that completes regulation. I think Kevin's at 84. My word for it yet.
I will never take your word for anything.
Well, you know what?
I'm just kidding, Effie.
I will start calling you Jennifer for the rest of the way.
The real Jennifer might not like that. She's pretty cool. I'll be right up there.
See ya.
Wait,
so that will be a first place tie at the moment, 84. So what do we do, gentlemen?
Say that is up to you guys. Where's the killer?
Keith Waters, present yourself.
All
right.
So you
were
my dead last spot.
You mean
to tell me I didn't finish?
Well, do you want to play the?
You can play 18 and we'll split the money. What do you
want to
play?
You got public.
Let's play 18 and we'll split the money. Charles gets 31.
My ball just always ends up in a bad spot and puts me in a bad situation.
I think Keith wants to go on the back.
You have to say what goes on.
Third.
Either Chase or Phil Nicholson.
Hold up. Well, let's. It's a psychological tactic, Chris, if you look at it that way. Okay. So it's going to be, we're going to have that playoff exclusively, but third goes to Brent Newman at 88 and tied for fourth. That's Graham Sigmund and Chase Ferguson at 89.
Yeah, I saw you on that one.
Next week we're going back to course one.
All right.
Yeah, this is going to be an unorthodox 18-hole playoff. I'm going to start on the back nine first. Mainly because of the public there on the front nine. Kevin. There he comes. Look at that. Keith will it was online and had the speed until it hit that little crack underneath the crusher.
Come out of the putt. Follow through on the putt.
Kevin gets ace there, so
you think
He'll enter the second hole of this playoff with a one-stroke lead. Okay, Kevin is now 2-for-2.
And
keeps it one down. Background, he's going to give it to you. And Keith gets it, so we're back to a tie. Two each. Gets it. Now to Kevin to match it. All right, Kevin matches it. So we deadlocked it 3-under. Now that's gonna be left. Slid off that left rail.
Hole there is.
Well, we're still on the back nine. Nope, he got the other type of kick off that reel. Oh, just skim past that second pipe. And it drops in. Kevin misses right.
It won't curve in here.
All right, he's now one back apiece. Going to 16, the second hole of this playoff.
Oh my God, just kick out, kick out.
Yep, he did, and he'll have a two-putt there. Oh, and he missed the deuce there.
I hate this damn hole when I miss it. I hate this hole. I just hate this damn hole.
All right. He drops back to 300. Gonna be right as well, but he'll get the
that three. Thing. I thought it was going to miss on that side.
He'll get the two. The playoff is still even, or it's back to even, I should say.
Oh,
all right, Kevin will have honors now on 17. This is the eighth hole of this playoff. We started on the back nine. We're gonna get to the front nine in a moment. Gonna have to putt for two. All right. And now, here's Keith. Going to be short.
Ain't up towards two. That's all he wanted on this hole.
Good strategy.
Right where I'm shot.
He remains 300 for the round. Wiping some perspiration off his hands here. It's been rather humid today. It started out at 85 degrees in High Point. The heat index was 92. It's still pretty oppressive here. That's not going to come back down. Hey, you got his two. Same spot Kevin's gonna be for his two.
Could have been in if I could hit it, bro. That was fun on the wall.
We are deadlocked at 300. We both shot 15 on the back. The only difference is that those three get that on 16. So we're now playing the final nine holes. This is Keith on one. And it lips around, good putt. Kevin has a one-stroke advantage. Going to Just let the toe of the play off. Off the block. Nope, that's going to be a two. All right, opportunity for Keith to square the match again. That's going to hit the left block. He'll get his two.
0 for 4.
Dickey is 4 under. Keith Waters 3 under. In for Kevin. Nope, he's this right, so he'll have a two. No, and that's no, short no, for Keith, no, and we're just down to six
that.
Holes
do
to
that.
Go.
Do that.
Kevin Dickey, 4 under par for this playoff.
It's just pitiful.
Keith Waters, 3 under par. 13th hole of this playoff right here. Nice putt. Now Keith desperately needs this ace here. That's a 31 cents 15. 6 holes ago. Last 7 holes. And that's just
see,
right.
I go under Eddie 4 times tonight. 4 times. Every time I hit that shot.
All right, now to the pivotal hole 5 where Kevin has been in trouble here tonight. He's hit the block twice, including the front part in the second round. Well, this is not over yet. Kevin's been behind the block tonight, so. And he also hit the block the third round. He just needs to calm down. No, you don't want to. We don't want to hit you. Much better. But he's going to be short.
Still a good ball.
Yep. So, here. So, Keith can ace it to cut it within one. Hurry. Same location. We have 4 holes remaining, and Kevin Dickey is up by 2. In there. Let's hit 600.
God's
sake. I don't believe that.
How did that miss?
I cannot believe that one. If I have any reason to pout over that one, that's the reason. Okay, we go to 7 with 3 holes left in the round. That's good. Keith's going to concede. So congratulations, I guess, to Kevin Dickey. What can I say?
What did I have him down there?
It's just Keith just wants to be Keith. Well, if he's got reason to pout, let me just say this. He did start the fight around 0-7. And he did shoot 8. Well, you were there. You watched.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, it's fortunate he got to that point of the tournament. So.
You can bogey the last three holes.
I wouldn't
let
you know. You gave me $20.
I'll give you the privilege of winning.
Thank you, buddy. All right.
All right.
Well, folks, let's look at the scores. That's more like the Jimmy Mott approach as far as playoffs go. You know, it sounds funny, but I'm being dead serious about it. Mott is a poor sport.
That was awful nice of them to let you win in the tournament.
Yeah, it only took 15 and a half holes.
You know, it could have ended right there.
It could have. Let's look at the scores right quick.
So that's a clarification. How many times have you answered?
Kevin wins the playoff.
I believe it's 4 times.
I'm gonna say 29-33 because it was 7-3 with 3 to play. So we'll just make that the final score of the playoff. And then third was Brent Newman. Actually, let's run it down right quick. Kevin and Keith shot 84. Brent is second. I'm sorry, third at 88, and in fourth tied was Chase Ferguson and Dylan Robertson. I'm sorry, Chase Ferguson and Grant Sigmund at 89.
Beat him into submission. It happens. If you were playing like crap, he would have left.
And let's get one more Yankee update.
I don't know. I've been helping customers. No update.
Ah, that's disappointing.
5-6 last I saw.
Oh, 5-6. Okay. All right. So we're going to wrap it up for tonight. I'm gonna be making my next broadcast on Saturday from Gastonia for the first time in 2022. So, for all of us here at High Point, we appreciate you watching and we'll see you on Saturday. Good night, everybody.